All right, you ready?
Oh, I'm so ready. Let's do it.
Hot topics.
Yes. One summer resort town in Wisconsin has been delivering mail the same way for more than 100 years.
I love this story.
By boat. That's right. Now, a tryout determines who's got what it takes to jump on and off the boat with letters in hand while the boat is moving. And it's an annual rite of passage for these people. So,
look at this.
Look.
I love telling this story every summer. This is something amazing. These teenagers are trying out boat jumping. Getting your mail by boat jumping.
By boat jumping. Look at that. And there's a reason sort of beyond the entertainment value to keep the boat moving. If it stopped, it would be at the mercy of the wind and the waves. So those who make the cut after these tryouts will spend about 2.5 hours a day working this unique mail route. Some people don't make it. Some people just crash and burn.
Darn it.
But it's not about whether you make it on the boat. It's whether you get up and try again.
Okay.
That's what I read.
Oh, she kissed that duck for good luck. Woo. I love to see it because some of these videos that I've seen, they're able to like do flips like on and off the boat. So pretty amazing. Really, really fun.
I feel like they could put the mailboxes closer sometimes. That one the girl just ran to was pretty far away.
Do you think we could try this on Beaver Lake?
I think we should.
It's worth a try, right?
The whole thing, yes. Boat jumping.
Can you swim?
I can. I'll be all right.
We're good. We're good. All right. Well, a video of 4 young men dancing outside of the Mississippi gas station. It is going viral. Take a look at this now. Features. These guys are getting down. At the gas station, you know, showing off their best moves. One of the members says that they had been swimming earlier in the day, and they decided to make a video. They all met up at a gas station and put on a show. The video was then posted to Facebook and has been shared thousands of times and even racked up millions of views. The boy says they've been friends for about 5 years.
That is awesome.
I love this. I love highlighting things that young people are doing in the community because, you know, you see a lot of the opposite. And so anytime young people are getting together and doing good and having fun, I like to highlight
that. I totally agree
with you. That's what these guys are doing. What about these dance moves, though?
This flossing? Which I've just learned is a thing, flossing.
Right. Do you know how to do it? Have your kids taught you?
Yes, my kids have taught me. They use some. They say.
I don't think I'm coordinated enough.
Break the stick.
Do it.
Put the stick back together.
Oh.
Switch sides. Break the stick. Put the stick back together. That's how they taught me.
I'm awkward.
I feel like in remedial classes, my kids are teaching me how to be cool.
Absolutely. We need to have our kids on to teach us the latest dance moves because we want to be hip.
We want to be hip, if only, right?
If only.
Speaking about hip.
Yes.
Anyway, let's talk about the World Cup. Yeah. Russia is taking the lead over its first World Cup opponent, Saudi Arabia, and the games haven't even kicked off yet. The meerkats at Drayton Manor Zoo in England are busy predicting the result of Thursday's World Cup opener, unanimously suggesting host Russia will get the better of Saudi Arabia.
Okay.
The Mystic Meerkats have successfully predicted results of the sports tournaments in the past, and also they suggest England, of course, would pick up a win with their opening match against Tunisia Monday.
Okay, so we had the cat that was the oracle of the World Cup.
That's
who picks the winner of the overall World Cup.
Yes.
And now we have these super cute meerkats who are picking per game.
Yep.
I dig it.
I mean, they're eating, right? Did somebody just put the food over there by Russia? Is that what happened?
Yeah. They put food over there to lure them.
Of course. You know, there's probably food in both places, right? Where are they going to go?